mini mi se nyankopon ehwe me ni ono na betuma hwe me but this state no mu no ye ni adwuma ha ene wo ma mindsefo e pam yen si yen san free ha ni nya de ye ye ni adwuma ye ye no ni yen se yen kwase ho ahoma o si yen nya den o ti sa ban ni mi se o pese o pam galamsey ni free ha de a on chasie eni ka me bia adwuma o me bia adwuma on fa adwa emra man so this state mu se jan shi so da ho what be bia adwa kama ye di adwa ho a me ko ja galamsey mti ata chenye me ho da because me creative me kura be ma me nyima adwuma ne chew ti meti ma ye nya sika chen se eno kura o mre be de fo na be do o ne me chew na me ye adwuma ni nya sika na me nyi hu nya fin o ne me chew no woni mu kwa aba fa so aba ye de woni problem but ya ban no fee se o bra galamsey o that no say on fa adwuma ma idea on ye careful na kron fo mind se fo na so mo mko nya me fee.
The state has actually established a national security task force on this small-scale mining, made up of the military, the police, the immigration, and the customs, and then they move around. Actually, the local police are not helpful when it comes to the issues of galamsey. So usually, when the national security is actually mobilizing forces, they probably even take them from stations which are not closer to those areas. And then they assemble them and then they take them to these areas. And even once you go there and then they get wind of it, somebody will pick a phone and then just relate the message to somebody that, yeah, your place is now an action point. It happens everywhere, yes. And I know that it is one of the problems that we are seriously confronted with.
For the negative impacts, I think we need, the response is not the use of the security agencies. I always have a problem with the use of soldiers and the police and the task force that go around arresting people and all that. That for me is not sustainable. I mean, because you can suck them off from the land today, you will not stay there forever. You will not be watching over the place forever. You will move out to another place to sack more people. Once you move out, they come back and do it. So it's not sustainable.
They are brought into the mainstream. That these people, now we know that we have been fighting this fight, but we are not winning. So how do we now engage them and let them work on these things on a sustainable basis? Or is it possible to give them an enclave for them to operate while they are adequately monitored? If we tell them that, well, within this area, it is for those who want to engage in small-scale artisanal mining. You are registered, we build your capacities, we tell you how to manage the environment, but you would have to pay fees and other things. I think you will find many good young men going there. Now, I'll be surprised to find people who haven't been trained as mining engineers to acquire concessions and the liberal terms also to mine. Don't forget that they employ people. Or they employ themselves. And because unemployment rate in Ghana is so high, if we have young men who want to bend their energies, bringing out gold, which government can buy and sell, why not? But the critical thing is that we have to be very careful that they don't destroy the environment.
So we need a lot more civilized method of engagement between the small-scale miners and the government. The government needs to be seen to be supporting them. Unfortunately, government support always goes to the large-scale miners.
We believe that illegal mining is illegal, but it's a shame that for so long we have not been able to take the very difficult decision to actually formalize a segment of the business which is actually recognized by law. And the key challenge is that how do you transform the artisanal and small-scale mine and illegal mining into small-scale mining? We also get concerned that a large part of Ghana's gold production comes from that segment. In fact, if you're able to aggregate all the production from that segment, it's larger than the production of any single mine. It just tells you how severe and serious the matter is. Therefore, it's our expectation that we would expedite action in the formalization as quickly as possible.
If we government got serious about helping them to formalize, then we could train them they need training. Some of these workers are, you know, they are very raw. They do not know much about the techniques of mining, how to handle chemicals and so on. Some of them are not even aware of the dangers of some of the chemicals they use.
We need a lot of research in these areas. What I did was just a small part of it. So there has been research by most of our professors in the university here, University of Mine Technology, as to the alternatives of using mercury. And I did know that the university was in collaboration with the Ministry of Mines, wanted to train this small-scale or galamsey operators in order to teach them some of these proper mining procedures, so that the pollution in these water bodies and the environment will be reduced.
So yes, going forward, there are a lot of things we need to do as a country. But on the whole, I am always for small-scale mining. I always advocate for small-scale mining on a very simple basis. That look, they are one of our own. They are Ghanaians. Most of them are Ghanaians. They are from the communities. They are indigenous. Whatever money they earn stays in the country, and that helps our development. Not those who come and mine and they leave up to 80%, 90% of their profits in offshore accounts. Why are you a pa? Nipa yina kase uyo.